Okay, so when you see a video from a YouTuber and they're talking about a product, do you trust that they like that product or are they promoting it? When they're talking about something, you've promoted, like an Elgato sometimes before? You've reviewed some other products. When you do that, you're making it pretty much clear, right? You're saying either this is a review or you'll make some sort of note in the description or something, right? That maybe you're promoting this or you're being paid for this or this is a review or something.
With Elgato, my first few reviews were actually done by myself, and then obviously they like what I did, and whenever I put, like, I know Miss Heart Attack has it, so does YouTubeable. They'll put powered by at Elgato, so it's from Elgato. That means they got paid for that video.
Okay, so here's the thing. There's some Xbox One sort of guerrilla marketing in a way from Machinima Partners. I'm a Machinima partner. I did not partake in this. We got some people that were upset that Machinima Partners were promoting the Xbox One. Not so much the Xbox One, but they didn't disclose it. They didn't say, hey guys, I'm being paid to talk about the Xbox One. So we got a bunch of YouTubers here. We got Noah.
Who? Hello.
Noah J. Who are you partnered with?
I'm currently with Fullscreen, so I...
Okay, Fullscreen. Not Yaush?
No, not Yaush.
Okay, so that's a totally different thing. Allie, you're part of Machinima?
Yes, I am.
Any other MCOM partners here? Dosha?
Mm-mm. Me, myself, and I.
Do you have a YouTube partnership? Do you deal with any of that stuff?
No, I don't. I thought about it. A friend talked me out of it. He's big on YouTube. He said, nah, you're good on your own. If anything.
All right, so I've done some YouTube promotions with MCOM, and what happens is either you put a code in the title or in the description, it says, because I was partnered through, MCOM, Shinema, they are compensating me for this thing. And by the and the ones that I did do, it wasn't like I was totally selling out. Like, a good example is they sent me a Need for Speed game and maybe 2 weeks early, which was awesome. And in the description I said, well, obviously, they sent it to me, so I'm going to talk about it and I'm going to show it to you guys. What you think about it? It was a pretty cool game. I'll make it clear. The problem with this Xbox One promotion is they didn't say anything. Like, they didn't make it a requirement. And, there's some scumbag YouTubers out there. They just, YouTube gaming is really competitive. Like, it's really super, I don't have to tell this to you guys. It's really competitive. And so if people don't have to mention that they're being paid to do something, sometimes they're just not gonna do it. So I guess the only person I could ask, really, Allie, since you're part of Machinima, did you take part in the Xbox One promo that got people worked up?
No, I didn't.
You didn't? But you have an Xbox One.
No, not yet.
Oh, not yet.
Okay, getting
one. So that's probably why.
So wait, did they send them out to people? Did they send Xbox Ones too, or did they just raise the CPM or something?
No, it was a 3 bonus CPM.
What? That's a lot! For what? Per thousand?
Yes.
Per 100? I don't know. I know they usually pay per 1,000. That's why I brought it up. That's ridiculous. That's a lot of money.
Oh, no. I can't talk about any of that stuff. I have limitations on what I can talk about. But
I guess I can, is it all right if I just, kind of...
You're
go
part
into
of Fullscreen. You could say whatever you want.
I'm not part of the Machinima Network here. But anyway, the thing that was, copy and pasted, put it on all these different forms and everything, was just, the deal was you get a bonus 3 CPM if you show some Xbox One gameplay, 30 seconds of gameplay. You show that. You talk about the Xbox One in a positive light. And that was basically the extent of the promotion. If you did those, if you met those requirements, I don't know what Machinima does with all that different promo stuff. You complete some steps to show that you did it, and you would get a bonus 3 CPM, which is cost per. I'm not sure what it actually stands for, but bonus $3 per 1,000 views.
You have to say nice things.
Yeah, you.
That's scumbaggish.
Honestly, it really wasn't anything bad. You just have to state why you're talking about the Xbox One. Like if I started rambling on about the Xbox One and how great it was, I'd have to say something about it. I had to mention it's part of a promotion. I'd have to put it in the description. The title would usually have like a code or something. That's how it's always been, because I have been part of a couple of promotions, but it's always been something that I actually like or something that I know about, something I can talk about, but it's never just a complete sellout like the E3 news. I'm going to cover the E3 news anyways, so you know, why not mention it during like a specific period that they want? So it's kind of a touchy thing, but a lot of people got mad when they found out that some of their favorite YouTubers were being paid to promote the Xbox One and they weren't telling their viewers about it. And mainly because they, which is kind of weird. You should be very open and honest when you're kind of, I don't want to say selling out. It's not a completely bad thing, but if you're promoting something, you should mention it.
What surprised me the most about it was that so many people were surprised and it was as big as it was, because I mean, even before I did YouTube, I could like point out the points and like other people's videos that I was watching where I'd be like, oh yeah, that was probably sponsored. They probably got paid to do something like that. I just found it amazing that a lot of people didn't realize that was like something that had been going on for a while, or like still don't realize that that's been going on for a long time. It's just now come into public light because someone leaked the email, I guess. And I think one of the Machinima representatives, someone, I'm not sure who, but I saw a tweet kind of like stating that check your emails for a special Xbox One CPM boost, something like that.
Oh, I see it. It's here, I'll look you guys.
They treated like COD XP.
It's from a Machinima, Ron Smith. I guess he's like one of the.
Oh yeah, here it is. Yeah, so he straight up says what the promo is, like publicly on Twitter.
He does.
So I mean, it wasn't like some huge secret. It's just that it kind of blew up.
And he deleted it.
Yeah.
It really wouldn't have blown up if people just put in the description or mentioned it's part of a promotion. And they just, for whatever reason, they made it to their partners where you don't have to mention, you don't have to say anything. And then it kind of bit them in the ass, so. But that's just common. Like if your favorite YouTuber is saying, all right, guys, but before I get in that commentary, I want to talk about, you know, Titanfall. Man, this game is awesome, and it comes out March 14th. Be sure to get it. Okay, now back to the commentary. Like I was saying, like, you know, if someone's talking about something out of the blue like that, or they're promoting something, they probably got paid for it. So that's just the dirty side of YouTube, but none of us were really involved in any of that.
I wish I was, though. Shoot, I'd have done that just because I already like Microsoft. That's free money right there. You don't have to convince me.
Yeah, $3 CPM is three extra dollars per 1,000 views. That's pretty good. Mm. It's kind of weird, mm-hmm. though, why Microsoft would kind of pay that much to.
I think it's like that. It's still in that time where people are still deciding on which console they want to buy. And if it seems like more YouTubers, more people that they watch, more of their friends all have the Xbox, then they're like, oh, I don't want to be left out of that. And that's the reason I got the Xbox in the first place. I've always been an Xbox guy, because when I was looking to buy a console, I asked all my friends what they had. They all played on the Xbox. They played Halo a lot. So I bought myself an Xbox. I think it's like the mentality, they're trying to make it seem like Xbox is where everyone is at, and it's a marketing strategy for the Xbox One.
Even more so, I think that the people looking in think this is a desperation act, and I think this is why it's blown out of proportion. They think Microsoft is losing, probably, I don't know, I'm assuming, to the PS4, so maybe they're throwing a hissy fit over that. It's like, oh, they're trying to buy more sales now because they lost. What a bunch of losers. It's kind of like buying YouTube views in a sense, you know what I mean? But doing it directly through big names like Machinima, like what Machinima has. I don't know, it's weird. I don't think it's a big deal either.
My thing is, like, we don't know half or most of the videos that come out, are they all even sponsored or not? Because it's so hush-hush. Right. We don't know.
That's CPM, though.
Well, I would never do that. And the few times I promoted a game or something, which is very rare, like maybe once a year. Like I said, the last time I did it was for the Need for Speed game. That was over a year and a half ago or so. And I made it clear. I mean, you can't hide. I mean, I had the game 2 weeks early. How am I going to do that and post it without getting a strike? You know what I mean? It was so clearly obvious. And even then, they didn't even say you had to say anything good. I could have trash talked the game if I wanted to. But I actually liked it. I thought it was fun. And so I'm like, yeah, I'm going to post this. It's cool. And I made it clear it was a promotion. It's just when you're sneaky about it, don't be sneaky. And I have seen YouTubers do that. Sometimes YouTubers that I like, and then all of a sudden, like a good one is the Hodge Twins. Do you guys know the Hodge Twins? Like they're these two twin vlogger guys.
Yeah. Oh, muscle junkies, yeah.
They're cool. They're cool dudes. But then all of a sudden one day they post this video, just they took like 2 minutes to promote this shitty ass movie with Sandra Bullock, and I like Sandra Bullock, but she made a shitty movie called Heat or it was a bad movie. It was bad. And the Hodge Twins were well, okay. In my opinion, it was.
I laughed at it. I thought it was
okay, but you're actually
wait, Hodge Twins and Sandra Bullock. That's the most random thing in the world.
Yeah, that is really random.
I would have automatically thought marketing. Okay,
that's interesting that you say that because the Hodge Twins are part of the same network as you, Noah. Did you promote the Sandra Bullock movie?
I did not partake in the heat promo, but I mean.
So you knew about it?
No, I don't think that.
It would have been funny.
It's just interesting that the Hodge Twins are part of Full Screen. You're part of Full Screen,
and that must have been a promotion from before I was with Full Screen. Because
why would you watch that movie? Because it seemed like a chick flick, kind of. It's
I actually went with my girlfriend at the time, and I didn't have high expectations for it. I heard from some girls that it was good. It was not it was kind of a chick flick. It had those moments, but I thought it was funny. It was just a little weird to hear Sandra Bullock like curse and try to be thug. I don't know.
Yeah, I seen trailers and I seen reviews of it because I like Sandra Bullock. She's made two back to back bad movies. I saw Gravity. And what's weird is Gravity got a lot of acclaim, and man, that shit was boring as hell. Anyways, the point is, Hodge Twins, I love them. I like their videos. They're funny. They have very funny characters. And then one day, they are just going on and on about the Heat, the Sandra Bullock movie. And
I'm so like, random.
What? I'm like, wow. And they didn't make it clear. I mean, it was obvious. It was so obvious it was paid for. But they just went off for 2 minutes. I couldn't believe it. And they got a good amount of dislikes, but I'm like, damn.
They at least chalk it up to like a man crush. Like Randy's like, you know, for some reason, you know, we want to put down the weights and talk about our man crush, Sandra Bullock. Let's go. You know?
Nope. Does it make any sense?
Wait, I have to ask them. Noah, have you ever participated in any Full Screen's promos ever?
The ones that I've done have all been things that I enjoy, and they're not like anything that's inside the video. My videos literally change zero, but it's kind of cool actually. It's something that they're kind of trying out, and I'm assuming they're liking it because they've been asking for a lot of them. I've done maybe like two or three of them, but they're like pre-roll ads, and basically instead of it just being like a random commercial that a company puts out, you watch it for 15 seconds and then you go into the video, they inter swap that out with like you. So I guess they have a connection with YouTube or something. So I've recorded like for an Anchorman 2 promo. I love Anchorman. No matter how stupid it is, I laugh every single time I watch Anchorman. They had a promo for Anchorman 2. I like got in front of the webcam, recorded a promo for it, and then that played in front of my videos rather than like whatever would have normally played there.
Mm-hmm.
So I've taken part in those before, yes.
I finally saw Anchorman 2-3 weeks ago.
Was it good?
No.
You're gonna get so many dislikes for that comment.
Now, I'm not... Oh, now, that movie's pretty old, right? It's been around for like 4 years, 5 years?
It's been around for a
while. Yeah, isn't there Anchorman 2 out?
Yeah.
All right. Wait, never right. saw it. And I know the memes, like I Love Lamp and all that shit. That's been around a long time. 5 years, I think. I don't even know. A long time. And so maybe because the movie has been hyped to shit, I was like, man, this is going to be funny as hell. Man, I can't wait. I'm going to laugh my ass off. I waited 10 years to see this movie. And I watch it. And it seems awkward. And Will Ferrell, and who's the big nose guy? The 40-year-old virgin. He's cool. Kelly Bundy's in there. I like her. And I didn't like it. I wasn't laughing. I laughed at a couple things. And I'm like, damn.
Don't see the second one then.
Do I gotta be stoned? Is it like a stoner movie? Like Pineapple Express? Because Pineapple Express seemed like a stoner movie. It didn't seem too funny. But then I don't smoke. But then I got drunk and I'm like, oh, this is
pretty funny.
Yeah,
I was drunk when I watched that and it was funny.
But then I have to ask myself, well, was it funny because I was under the influence of something? Because, you know, things are more funny. People are more attractive once you drink certain things, smoke certain things. So, Noah, when you watched Anchorman, were you under the influence of anything?
No. No, I just watched that straight up and cannot stop laughing. It's something about the humor and that I just accept that, like, I'm taking myself down a whole nother level of intelligence to laugh at it. But it's, I don't know. I've always been a fan of the Anchorman series. And well, for some reason, like if anyone else does it, but it's not as funny, but the kind of characters that Will Ferrell plays just, I don't know. There's something about them that get me. And I know I'm not alone in that just because of how many fans that Anchorman series has, but
he's pretty genuine. He even does that in like person. Like he'll go to an event and he'll do something crazy.
No, I did read one story. This is a long time ago. But if you've ever seen the drummer for the Red Hot Chili Peppers, he and Will Ferrell look like extremely similar. And there's a story about how he went up to I don't know what his name is, but the drummer, he was doing an interview or something like that. He walked up to him and like during the interview told him like, "You're a very attractive man," because they look almost exactly alike, and just walked away. Like he's the kind of person just like do stuff like that. Yep.
Yeah, I can't. Yeah, I've seen the guy, but I don't remember his name.
Yeah.
Okay, so you liked Anchorman, so you promoted it. Okay, that's good. See, I didn't like it, so I wouldn't be caught dead promoting it. That's just me. Okay, awkward silence. But real quick though, we're talking about people getting mad over the X-Bone. So I don't have one. I plan to get one, obviously. Noah, you have one already, right?
Si, senor.
Mew, you are about to get one.
Yes, I am.
You sold your PS3 and Xbox or something? What happened?
Yes, I went on a huge eBay selling auction thing. I auctioned everything that I owned from the Xbox 360 and the PS4, like all my games, controllers, some headsets. Mm-hmm. And that shit that I got was enough to pay for an X-Bone and some games, which is awesome.
Okay, cool. So we got two people pretty much going to have one. Dosha, you were helping promote the Xbox One. You went to their event and all that stuff. So you must have one by now.
Nope. Right?
Nope.
Nope. No, not yet. I was supposed to get one. Put that stuff towards a car. I'm buying a car for myself. It's a little more important. So I'm like, all right, well, I mean, do I get an X-Bone or do I get a vehicular module? Yeah, I chose the latter.
Yeah, some transportation. So, but you're going to get one eventually, though.
Yeah, of course. Probably next month.
Yeah, I have to get one eventually, too. It sold really well. It sold really well. The X-Bone, let's see, we have some numbers finally. The Microsoft put their earnings out. They made $24 billion. They had $6 billion profit. And they sold almost 4 million Xbox Ones. That's pretty good, I think. 4 million Xbox Ones, considering there's no real games out.
Yeah, that's actually kind of amazing now that, like, I think about it. There's literally no games.
Like, yeah, of course there's video games out, but like for us hardcore gamers, you know all those games are garbage. Come on now.
Yeah.
Right, Son of Rome.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I mean, I'm waiting until Titanfall comes out. Have you guys seen the Titanfall gameplay? People have been leaking it. You can watch it like on these Russian websites and
totally didn't get some hands-on time with that.
Wait. They had the Expo in beta. Were you part of that? I know Wicked Shrapnel was.
I mean, speaking in general terms here, they may or may not have had an alpha, and I may or may not have participated in said alpha. But under the NDA, I'm not really...
Oh, okay. You can't talk about it. All right, that's fine.
I don't want to get this video taken down or anything.
All right, that's fine. You stay hush-hush. Basically, yeah, some YouTube people... You don't have to be a YouTube person. They just let normal people do. You get to play the alpha, and obviously you can't post that on YouTube. It'll get taken down. It's kind of weird. I think they expect that... They expect these YouTubers to sort of leak it on, what's a daily video or
Daily Motion?
Daily Motion. You can see the gameplays on Daily Motion. I see one on Vine, really short gameplay. I see one on Tube.ru, which is like a Russian. You see all kinds of lots of Russian websites. And I haven't seen any gameplay where the person is taking advantage of the jumping around and stuff. But the game looks like Call of Duty with some mechs and stuff. It looks cool, though. I don't know, I can't talk about it, and it sucks. But I'll have some links. I'll have links to some leaked gameplay, what I've seen, if it's still up. But you can just... Google it or something.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna cry that it's over.
Anyways, what's up?
Oh no, I was gonna say when I played it, because a lot of people played it on like at PAX and stuff. It felt like Call of Duty. It feels like home. Except I noticed also nobody uses that thing where you run on the walls. Nobody knows how to do that. I never did it.
Yeah, I'm gonna utilize that. The gameplay that I've seen, you can tell the people are Call of Duty players. Like, they're doing jump strafing and drop shotting and shit like that. Like, you could just tell from watching, okay, this person plays Call of Duty. But they're not, like, leaping on the walls and doing all the crazy shit that is what the game was supposed to be about. It's supposed to be, yes, it's Call of Duty. It's made by the former Infinity Ward members. But you have parkour and you have mechs. So whatever, it looks very exciting. I finally seen the pre-order controller. That Xbox One controller looks sick.
It does.
That's the orange and white one, right? Is that mm-hmm. that one?
And I normally don't get all giddy over these stupid pre-order things, but it looks pretty beast. So I'm gonna just finally get a next gen something. Mm-hmm. While we're talking about the Xbox real quick, how come YouTubers, someone sent me this on Facebook, why do a lot of YouTubers use Xbox? What's up with that?
Oh, I know, for now.
You know?
Yeah.
Why?
Currently, right now on the PS4, they were allowed to use capture cards. Right now, capture cards don't work on PS4 until maybe an update will happen.
No. I'm talking about in general. In general, YouTubers are always on Xbox.
Well, how would you like record your footage if your capture card doesn't work on it?
So you think it's because of capture cards? Like I'm talking about like 3-4 years ago when gaming.
Oh, like 360.
Yeah, I'm talking about the 360.
I think it's Xbox exclusivity. I don't even know if that's a real word, but. Like, the Call of Duty gets every games monthly, right? For the DLCs and everything.
Yeah.
A whole month before that. That's a significant amount of time. And for YouTubers who cover that game, I think it just got established early on as the YouTuber console. That's what all your other YouTube friends do. That's what all your friends do in real life. I don't know. I feel like the 360 was definitely the dominant console out of the PS3 and Xbox, and that's a little bit of a biased opinion, but I don't know.
I think so too, because like I'm thinking about all the exclusive games that the multiplayer has and that a lot of YouTubers make, like Halo. There's a huge community for that I know of YouTubers that make those videos too. I don't know if PS4 people who have some other multiplayer game. I haven't seen a lot of, like, all I see is really Call of Duty, Battlefield, and Halo videos. So, yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't see Killzone, like, at all.
Is there any Killzone YouTubers that just constantly make Killzone montages?
I'll see stuff like Payday, right? But you can play that on PC. Most of the stuff you see is on PC, so it's like, either you get Xbox exclusives, since those seem to be more popular, or whatever's on the PS3 is most likely on the PC, so they'll just do the PC version. That's what I see, at least. I don't know.
The only game that I can remember in recent history that made me say, man, I really wish I had a PS3, was The Last of Us. And like, yeah. that was more of like a playthrough game, not really a post on YouTube game, for me anyway. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, some people told me to play the multiplayer of it really wasn't for me.
Yeah,
it's goofy. I play that a lot. It's the most broken. It's broken. Imagine Gears of War, but it didn't work. Like that's The Last of Us multiplayer. I love
even,
it.
Even more so than the Gears of War didn't work when they shut off all the dedicated servers.
Yeah, that, oh, no. Yeah.
So did everyone here? I mean, everyone here play Last of Us all the way through?
I did. Yes.
You did, Mew?
No.
No?
No, I didn't play all the way through.
That's a blasphemy. You have access to it.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to watch your videos.
that's very nice of you. So, Noah, you're never going to play it then?
Probably. I might, over the summer, maybe like go out and rent it, or it'll probably be pretty cheap by then. My brother has a PS3. I might just take over his room for a week or so and beat it.
Yeah, but, yeah. Yeah, everyone went on how it was Game of the Year, and it was more like Interactive Movie of the Year, I think. Mm. I can
agree with that.
So I think GTA was kind of Game of the Year, like it was a video game. It was awesome. Does anyone here watch Angry Joe or know who Angry Joe is?
I used to watch a lot of him when he was on that guy with the glasses.
Okay, yeah, he's a cool PC gamer, pretty much. He does it, which is kind of boggling. He doesn't own a PS3. And the dude's got like a million subs or something. Like, he's up there. And he's never played The Last of Us because he doesn't own a PS3. Very odd.
Yeah, it is odd.
That someone
makes
of
his, no sense.
Yeah, someone of his caliber, which could buy a PS3 for half a video's views or something, and he just doesn't want to buy one. So his top 10 list didn't include Last of Us. I was like, what the? That was kind of weird. Anyways, I think, are we ready for something else here? Mm-hmm. Well, this is kind of off topic. I know I was saying how I don't like Anchorman, and maybe it's because I wasn't under the influence of something. I wasn't smoking. And I've said this before. A lot of people have said this. But this is my personal opinion. We're going to talk about some pot right now real quick because, you know, it's still kind of fresh issue because Colorado legalized it. Obama said that pot is not very different from cigarettes and it's no more dangerous than booze. That's a good assessment, right? I think we can all agree with that. Do you think cigarettes are worse than... What's worse, cigarettes or pot? Cigarettes, which we know causes cancer and kills babies.
Research-wise, I'd say cigarettes is more stuff saying that cigarettes are killing you than pot.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, yeah. If you smoke cigarettes, you know damn well you're going to get cancer. Right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. Now, if we and I'm not, I, by the way, people already know this, I don't smoke pot. And if you smoke a joint, what's going to happen to you?
You get high.
You get high? You're going to be opening up a Twinkie, like I hear someone in the background opening up a Twinkie right now.
It's a Nutri-Grain.
Same thing.
Same thing, you get the munchies. Are you sure you're not smoking, Noah?
No, fun fact for a the viewers out there, I've never been under the influence of anything my entire life.
Huh.
Freshman in college.
All right.
Mikey doesn't believe it.
We're going to have to fix that at PAX or something.
Oh, man.
Noah, you ever been to any gaming events, met YouTubers and stuff?
I live in the perfect area, right in the smack dab middle of the United States, where there's no gaming events aside from UNV Dallas.
Oh, wow.
Sorry, I just had a mouthful of Nutri-Grain during that sentence. Are you getting
paid to promote Nutri-Grain?
I was saying the disclaimer for the end. This video is sponsored by Nutri-Grain.
Yeah, I want to know the CPM on that one.
two boxes of Nutri-Grain.
But a lot of people just fly out to PAX, though. They just fly out there. Everyone does. No interest. Okay, I was just curious if you met anyone.
I've never been out. I definitely want to at some point, but as where I am right now, poor college student, don't have any plans for this year. Maybe next year.
Okay, before we get way too deep into the podcast, people want to hear about Bieber. And, hell, even MSNBC cut a reporter doing a legit news story. They said, "I'm sorry, Murray, but we have big news. Justin Bieber has been arrested."
I think it was a senator, a U.S. senator.
Unbelievable. A retired 19-year-old former YouTuber, and he just got fed up. He don't want to make music anymore, so he's been screwed around. We talked about it like 2 weeks ago, or what was it, last week or 2 weeks?
Yeah, we talked about it for a good 3 weeks straight now.
He was throwing eggs at us. It's
like a common topic now for us.
Look, he's a fucking 19-year-old who likes to get high and drunk. Okay, he's gonna do that shit. He just so happens to be a multimillionaire. And I don't even listen to the dude's music. I'm not even a fan of the guy. Doshas, that's your boy. You like this dude.
Okay. For the record, I can't stand Bieber's monkey ass. I just like playing Doshas advocate. But that's neither here nor there. In this podcast, I'm a fan of his. And even I think something's wrong with the kid. The shit he's doing,
I did. I threw eggs at people's houses. I threw eggs at my ex-girlfriend's house. I threw eggs at people who I didn't like. I smashed stuff at people I didn't like. Except I didn't have millions of dollars. And I didn't have a billion Twitter followers and all that shit.
I think that makes a difference. He's Bugatti Bieber. You know what I'm saying? He's Bieber-velly. He's this super thug Bieber now. And he's a kid, though. And I think the media needs to understand that. Like, yo, chill a little bit, you know?
Yeah, he's famous. He brings in views, so... That's gotta be. I feel sorry for the dude. He's 19. He wants to have fun and act out and do fucking 19. I don't know. People say, "Oh, you're 19. You should act like an adult." But all right, whatever. So
I have to interject a little bit on that. I'm all for doing whatever you want to do. If you want to throw eggs at your neighbor's house, that's fine. I don't keep up with the latest Biebs trends, but the only thing that I had a problem with is the fact that he put other people's like safety in danger when he decided to drive under the influence. That's where I don't care.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, this dude's racing down the street, and you know what's even worse? It's like the people he's hanging out with, they're not trying to check him. Everybody that's around him is just trying to cash in on it. He was with some football player's ex girlfriend. You know, she a thot. She was only there for the money. Come on now, and This I don't know, he can use better guidance, and the people around him, like, you saw the people who got arrested. Remember Lil Za from last week, his weed carriers? You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. My boy.
You know, Sean Kingston stopped hanging out with him now. Like, you know, like what in the world? Who are the people you hanging out with? And they're all thoughts too, all of them. So it's like, he's got to turn down a little bit, but even more so, he just needs better people in his corner to tell him, no, don't do that. That's not how you behave.
Yeah, but he's Bieber.
Bieber-velly. Bieber. Bieber Flocka. What do they call him now? He's got so many nicknames. Oh, he's a super thug now. Now he went to prison. You see his mugshot? That was another big thing. That's all over the place. I put that on my Instagram, his mugshot.
I know. I saw a picture. It's like all spammed throughout my Facebook of Bieber right next to Miley Cyrus, and they look kind of similar now.
Well, there's that one, but he got arrested. They put his mugshots on it. I think I don't know if it was today or yesterday, and he's all smiling in them. It's the silliest looking thing, but yeah, they finally bagged Bieber, and I know I could tell by the smile on his face. He thinks he's a thug now, so you know, look out for the next hip hop album, Bieber Velly. You know, realest N word alive, or I don't know what the hell you'd call that crap, but you know, I don't know. Bieber needs to turn down. I think he needs to learn how to behave. And hopefully this will help him. I don't think any of his friends is going to do anything for him, though. So he might be screwed.
I don't know. I'm just looking for, like, every week, like, what's the next thing that Bieber's going to do? Like, what's the next thing? Because it seems like he's just doing something every week.
It's weird. Remember a year and a half ago, this was all Rihanna. All we would hear about was Chris Brown and Rihanna. Now I got to hear about Bieber again. Like, come on, man. Get this shit. Whatever.
He didn't even do anything really bad, though. He did... He was doing typical 19-year-old shit. What happened was he was in Florida being paid to be at a club. He must have been paid a lot. I don't know how much they paid him, but he was there at a club. Him and, some football star's ex-girlfriend, don't even know what her name is. I mean, she's cute, whatever. She's a good-looking chick. And then he's with another artist off of Def Jam, Khalili?
I don't know.
Never heard of the dude. He's hanging around with all these people, like you said, weed carriers, all these random people. The problem is, he's a 19-year-old multimillionaire, and there's not too many 19-year-old multimillionaires for him to hang out with. So he's hanging around with all these fucking leeches. That's a problem. Anyways, but he's promoting a club, and that's normal for a lot of celebrities to do that. He's promoting a club. He's hanging out there. He gets to be seen there. They gave him free everything. They got him and Khalil Lambos. They gave him a Lambo and they gave his friend a Lamborghini to use for the weekend while they're there. They probably paid for their room and all that shit.
Nice. Because
that's a big promotion. Justin Bieber hangs out at club whatever the fuck.
Wait, isn't that illegal? You say he's 19. They giving him free liquor? That just dawned on me. That whatever. Continue.
So they're leaving the club, and they have a lot of fucking chicks and people around them. It's causing a big ruckus, because he's Bieber, right? He's famous. He's number one pop star, whatever. And all those people in the street, he's holding up traffic, and a cop notices them. And him and his friend, they speed off in their Lambo, Ferraris, whatever. And when they speed off, it really wasn't a speed contest. Because I've been part of speed contests when I used to drag race and I was part of the car club scene. There's video of it. You could see, like, people were videotaping the shit and putting it on Vine, Instagram, whatever. You can watch it. Him and his friend, they took off their Lambos. Yeah, they're drunk and they sped off, but they really weren't racing. They hit 60 max, if that. 60 miles per hour. Should they have been doing it? No, you shouldn't be fucking driving after you've been drinking, smoking, whatever. Cop pulls him over, and Bieber, being kind of buzzed, I think he blew a .04. The legal limit to be drunk in most states is 0.8. I've been 0.8. It ain't really shit. I mean, you're kind of fucked up, you're kind of buzzed. It ain't really nothing, but he's 19, and he's probably weighs 100 pounds. He freaked out, and he said, why are you doing, like, you never yell at a cop. Ever. You never yell at a cop. You fucking listen and you do what they say. But he had to yell and said, why are you doing this? Why are you arresting me? Do you know who I am? And all this crap. And so, of course, that's going to make it worse. So then he got resisting arrest without violence or some weird technical shit. So he didn't, like, fight the cop, but he kind of gave him a hard time. And then that other Khalili guy was arrested. The point is, he got fined like $2,500 for all this, all these shenanigans.
That's nothing.
That ain't shit. Yeah. He makes like that's fucking nothing. 10 grand a day from all his fucking music sales.
Yeah, it's nothing.
So what did he do? So him and his friend are goofing off in the car, and they were speeding. I don't know. Like, I've kind of been there in his situation. I kind of feel for him. I don't think it's really that big a deal, but he's fucking world famous.
I think they're just making a statement. But what was weird about the whole report is, like you said, MSNBC. MSNBC, I think it was?
Yeah.
They stopped what they were doing to cover that. ESPN
Yeah,
covering it. Like, why?
meanwhile, there's children in Syria carrying AK-47s, fighting each other right now. There's a lot of war going on over there in Syria right now, and there's a lot of children fighters, but no one gives a fuck. We want to know about Bieber.
Bugatti Biebs, realest N-word alive. Let's go.
But when you break it down, if you strip away Bieber's name, he did what a lot of people his age are doing. Unfortunately, you should never ever fucking drink and drive. Never do that shit. But he was screwing around with his friend. He's showing off. He's with this model chick. I don't know what her name is. Don't care. But I don't know. People are like, oh, well, he's gonna be like Miley or Lindsay Lohan. You know, go down the drain. I don't think he's going down the drain. I don't think he's doing anything so crazy out of the ordinary.
I don't think he himself is, but it's the people with him. They're gonna make him do it.
Yeah, because I did look into the Khalil guy, Khalili, whatever, and he's a decent singer. Like, I wanted to be informed of who this person was before I said he was a nobody. It's not like he's a nobody, but he's kind of like an R&B version of Little Twist or Little Ka, or who was the one last week?
Little Za, yeah.
Little Za. He's like he could sing. He had a cool rap video or R&B video. I don't know. He's a talented dude, but no one's ever heard of him. I never heard of Khalili.
Yeah, those dudes are usually tax write-offs or, like I said earlier, weed carriers. They're talented. They have skills, but they don't really have a buzz.
And then he's hanging around with some chick who was just... All she is good-looking. She hasn't done anything with her life. She's a good-looking woman who hooked up with a football player, and now somehow she's hanging around with Justin Bieber. She's like a high-end groupie or something. Like, he hangs around with a bunch of leeches. Every time he gets in trouble, he's with a leech. So, I kind of feel sorry for the dude, but whatever, like, that's... It must suck to be a millionaire. Who wants to be a multi-millionaire, right?
Yeah, it's so boring.
That's really suck.
I don't know. Actually, I kind of have a little true story. One of my friends growing up, he got hit by a car when he was 8 or 9. And the car really fucked him up. It scarred his face. He lived. Like, he wasn't disabled or anything. He just had, like, a physical scar on his face, a couple scars on his arm. And the thing was, when he turned 18, he could access the settlement. The settlement was... close to $200,000, and 200K, that's a good amount to anybody, but that's a lot of money to a fucking 18-year-old who's kind of, I'm not going to say my friend's a loser, but we kind of just were party people. We didn't give a fuck about our future. We just partied and shit. And so you give 200 grand to a kid, pretty much, because when you turn 18, you're not just a fucking adult all of a sudden.
Yeah.
You're still a kid.
Yeah.
Especially if you're an 18-year-old dude. You're still a fucking kid. So he had all that money. And I wasn't a leech. I was his friend before all this crap happened. And I had a job. And I never leech off him. I want to make that clear. But he all of a sudden had a whole bunch of new friends. And every day everyone was smoking and drinking, and he had this new stripper girlfriend, and she wanted to have fur coats and rings and all this crap. And it doesn't matter, when you have money, people will flock to you like flies to shit. Sure. So it's a whole new set of problems. Sucks. So and then he ended up being broke because he spent all his money before he was 21. Very sad. So maybe that's what's going to happen to Bieber. I don't know. But every time he gets in trouble, he's hanging around some leeches or weed carriers, as Josh likes to call them. Whatever. All right, we're done with the Biebs. What, anyone want to mention anything else about that dude?
Apparently he snitched on his mother, but we'll get into that next week. Yeah, I don't really we'll know the whole thing.
We'll save that one for next week.
Yeah, there's so much Bieb to go around. We'll cover the mom snitching next week.
All right, what are we talking about next? Are we talking about porn stars or...
I like porn.
You want to talk about porn stars?
Do it.
Now,
that one came from me.
What happened? Who is this? What happened, Mia? Who is this person?
All right, I don't know if you guys know the porn star Christy Mack. She announced on Twitter that she'll give a blowjob to whoever makes the best Lego creation for her. You can find her Twitter page. Yeah.
What? Yo, buddy, get on Lego right now. Let's
all right, now listen up.
Just at the old set right now.
Listen up. Christy Mack is my girl. I've been following her on Instagram for like a year now. This girl is fine as fuck. She is curvy and thick, and she's got this sick ass hairstyle. Like her sides are like shaved. She has like this big ass mohawk kind of. She's got like this cool style. She's always posting pictures of like her fucking pit bulls and shit and her snakes. She's a cool chick.
You do a lot of research on her, actually.
I research her. But she's got a fucking boyfriend.
For science.
She's got a boy.
What's her last name? I'm trying to like see.
Christy Mack.
Like. Christy Mack.
She's beautiful. She's a beautiful woman. She's got.
She's
cool
actually really pretty with tattoos.
Yeah, she's your like, girl.
He's like, I've seen her before.
She like wears corsets, so. This part is kind of weird. She does wear corsets to train her body so that she has like that hourglass figure or whatever. Anyways, she's got a boyfriend, some MMA fighter, War Machine. I don't know. Some people might know who he is. War Machine. The dude's fucking dangerous. He's pretty crazy. He was arrested and police put a spit bag over his head. And a spit bag is basically when officers have to arrest someone who's crazy and have to put this bag over the head so they don't spit on them and bite them and stuff. He had one of those on his head. You can Google that shit on TMZ. Anyway, so I've done a little bit of research into Christy Mack. But the BJ thing, she was joking. She wouldn't do that. She doesn't do that kind of thing. I mean, not unless she's paid. I think she was joking, and I think some people blew it out of proportion. Christy Mack is a cool chick. She's awesome. I would like to meet her one day. Who knows? Maybe we can get her on here. I don't know.
Maybe you should just try making something with the Lego.
Yeah, I will get some Legos. Go get some Legos, man.
Come on to my podcast.
What's funny? It's kind of weird. I've never actually watched any of her videos. I just know her from Instagram. That's it.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I don't want to watch any of her videos.
Wow, dude, your research sucks.
That might kill it for me. I don't want to see her doing any of that stuff with other guys.
I don't understand the, like, okay, so, okay, this has always occurred to me, and I've always talked about it. How would you feel if your girlfriend was a porn star? Would you be okay with it?
That's a good question.
Because there's always a different guy boning your girl.
Well, I guess if you met them, right, and you knew that that's what they did, you're kind of already sold to it, so you're already accepting of the fact that that happened. But if you just, like, found out that she just kind of gets paid to do that, I guess I'd be okay with it if I knew going in and I still bought into it, right?
Going in?
Yeah. No. Going in.
No, shit. Yeah, I walked into that one, huh? Oh, I don't even know how to follow up, but yeah, if I knew, then I would probably, but nah.
You went too deep.
This guy's a perv, man. I love it.
No, that's a career path that she kind of has to, like, talk about right up front. Or if you met her, then you would probably already know. Like, I'm pretty sure War Machine, he already knew about this going into it. But she said that him and her, they still kind of have like issues about it. You know, it's normal for him to be jealous. He's a fucking aggro male, alpha male fighter. He beats up people, you know. So he can't be too happy about it. But they deal with it. Now you're saying, how would I feel if my girlfriend did that? I would. When I met her, she would have to make it clear right from the get-go, and if me and her, our bond is so strong and And she made it clear, like, right from the fucking damn letter. At times, oh, surprise, you know, 6 months later, by the way, this is what I do. That's different. I think it's possible. It's possible for me to date someone who did that. But I'd have to fucking know right from the damn letter. You know, hey, maybe I meet Christy Mack. You know, like, I already know who she is. I know what she does for a living. And move on. But, and that comes with a lot of hurdles, because you have the whole STD thing you gotta worry about. That's the main thing. I don't know, that's the main thing I'd be very worried about, the STD and mm-hmm. viral viruses and stuff like that. But yeah, it's possible. I would never say never, but I had to know right from the fucking day I met him. So
would you go on a, but other than that, would you go on a date with a porn star?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I wouldn't count anyone out. Absolutely. Who knows? You never know. Could be fun. Yeah, I've dated some pretty crazy women, so a porn star wouldn't be so far fetched for me.
Well, you do live in California, yeah.
It makes me wonder what type of girls he has dated now.
I tend to like independent women, aggressive women, but sometimes
tattoos.
Not. I mean, tattoos. Everyone has tattoos. Tattoos aren't like, doesn't mean that you're a bad person or something anymore. Tattoos and piercings and all that stuff, that's just a form of body modification and expression.
Wow, that's deep.
But maybe one of these days I could talk about the one chick I had to threaten her with a restraining order.
Oh man!
But this was
you're definitely from California.
But this was like a year and a half ago, and what's funny is, no. This was 2 years ago, and never heard from her after I threatened her with the restraining order. But then like 2 days ago, I had a dream about her, and I missed her. Yeah. So.
Aww. Mikey. That's not creepy at all.
Yeah, I should have missed people like that. So how do we go on from that?
Well, we got more porn to talk about.
Wait, before you start to do a show, did you guys all notice that Noah never responded? It's probably because he was watching a video.
I've been silently researching over here. You guys,
look at
we got a new scientist over here. All snap.
Tissue box. Do you need a tissue box, sir?
I've got one. Thanks.
Seriously, look up Christy Mack on Instagram. She posts beautiful pictures.
No, I know.
If she's not for everybody. Like she's not a little skinny girl. She's curvy. That's not for everybody. And she's got a lot of tattoos too. All those tattoos. She got that. I don't even know what's that hairstyle called. It almost looks like a Skrillex hairstyle, but it's cool.
I don't know, but it looks really cool.
It looks fucking hot. It's like a big ass mohawk, but she doesn't wear it like a mohawk. She just has like her, I don't know, man, she's cool. Google her. All right, what's the next thing?
So real quick, since you brought that up, I actually finally found the article. There's another porn star date related tweet out there. This one was about a kid. He made a sign and he showed it during one of the broadcasts. It was about what's her name? Just looked at it and I forgot her name. Lisa Ann. Yes. So I forgot exactly what the sign says. I gotta find it. But the porn star Lisa Ann liked the sign so much that she was tweeting at him, and this actually made the headlines and wanted to go. It says Baylor's defense has more hole to fill than Lisa Ann, and Lisa Ann saw that sign and she liked it so much that she wanted to take him on a date and to one of the college football games. So that was kind of a win in the books there for both the college kid and the porn star. So that was pretty awesome.
That's funny.
Yeah, so I thought I'd throw that in there as well, since, you know, we've got all this porn here, thanks to Sally.
You're welcome.
You do a lot of good research, too. God, you all are good researchers. Huh? You set my up.
So, we're ready for the next topic?
Yeah, sure.
So, speaking of porn and stuff, you, Twitch TV. Noah, you live stream?
Not my porn escapades.
Well, I'm
a webcam girl.
I'm a webcam girl.
Harry, someone rain tokens on him.
All right, so Noah, you're on Twitch. You stream. Everyone here streams pretty much, except for me.
Yeah.
Twitch TV has banned a video game from being on there. Can you guess what game they have banned? You cannot stream this particular video game on Twitch. It must be so bad that they won't allow you to stream it. What game do you think it'd be?
I would have said like Leisure Suit Larry.
So it must be so violent.
I don't know.
The only one I can think of is this game I saw coming out for the, what's it called? Oculus Rift or whatever. That's like literally a sex game.
You're pretty close. The game is called Second Life, and it has pretty much turned into a sex game.
Huh.
Anyone here play Second Life?
No. Is it like Half-Life with more life? I don't know.
Really?
No.
Wait, I think I've heard of that before.
Nobody here has played Second Life.
I feel like you made a reference to that on The Office. Does anyone watch The Office?
I do.
Second Life.
Second Life is basically a pornographic version of GTA, except there's no guns and no killing, and it's just basically people acting out their sexual fantasies in a open world, user created environment. And no one who's played it. Okay, well, you can't play that game anymore, because even if you wanted to innocently play Second Life, you can't, because there's penises everywhere, pretty much. I don't know how else to say this. There's peni everywhere, all over the game, and it's so rampant that you can't even open up the screen without seeing a penis.
Wait, isn't Rust the same way? If you, for those, I don't know if you guys have played Rust, but when when you start Rust, you're butt naked, like literally butt naked, dingling, dangling, just running in the woods. And there's nothing you can do about it. That's weird.
But that's not sexualized. You're thrown into the environment naked. That's different.
Okay, that's true.
Second Life, you can interact with other people.
Oh yeah, that's... Yeah.
It's bad. It's really bad. And I know this because I played it for a while when I was younger.
Was it as bad as it was then?
I played it maybe 5-6 years ago. I can't even imagine how bad Second Life must be now, but it's just freaking freaky bondage, and I'm afraid of even describing what you find in that game. Like, I'm surprised people still play it, let alone want to stream it, but it's basically a place for people to facilitate their fantasies, and maybe one of these days I'll talk into the story how I actually met a girl in real life off of Second Life. And
yo, these stories, man.
I know.
Yo, what?
Lives, like,
restraining orders, porn stars, Second Life. Yo, I don't.
Second Life avatars.
Oh my god, Mike.
The people in there are freaks, and I think Twitch is in the right for black in this game. It's on its way out. Not too many people play it. You have to be a hardcore freak to keep playing this game. It was really big a couple years ago, but it's died out now.
Wait, when did this come out?
Second Life has been out a long time, but Twitch finally, just this week, they prevent you from live streaming it, just because there's so much sexual activity in this game.
Right.
It's disgusting. Crazy. It's disgusting because there's children in there. The game is free. Anyone can play it. It really is disgusting. There needs to be some way to prevent children from playing it. But anyone can download it. So
yeah, it has been around for a while. That I found the Office clip that I was thinking of where Dwight talks about Second Life, and it's from 2007. So this game's been out for a while.
Yeah, it's been out. But Mikey, when I think of Second Life, I remember people also saying that you can actually make real money like off of it, or you pay for like a house.
Yeah. It's you create objects. You can create a car, create a house, create clothing. And there was one girl who made $30,000 a year creating virtual clothing that people could buy. So you put money into your Second Life account, and with that real money, you can buy stuff. And this girl was so good at creating Second Life clothing. Like, she was like a fashion designer in real life. And yeah, it could work. Probably not now because the game is pretty much dead. But at its peak, yes, people were actually making a living selling their objects. Mostly it was clothing, cool clothing. People really wanted the clothing. But now it's just so diluted. So, but yeah.
That's crazy.
But we're getting towards the end here. Should we go around the end where everyone's watching, playing and stuff? Should we start with Sally, ladies first? Ali, what are you watching? Are you watching any series, movies? What are you playing right now?
I think, I feel like a kid. I've been watching anime.
What anime? That's racist. Why are you Asian and watching anime?
I just so happen to like anime, okay? Not all Asian people like anime, okay?
What series? Because people want to know. I know I have some...
I'm gonna let you guys know, if anybody here watches anime, the best place to stream it is called AnimeSeason.com. I've been watching and catching up with Fairy Tail, which I really enjoy. It's a really good one. Oh, Shidosha watches anime. He's a fucking otaku in a closet.
So here we go.
Shidosha's a weeaboo.
She dodged labels to label me. That's pretty good. You guys are nerds. Continue.
I know. Okay, well, you want to describe what Fairy Tail is? It's...
No, I don't, actually. Nope.
Why?
You can do that. I'm good, because I shouldn't have been watching it anyway.
Okay, well, Fairy Tail is kind of like, if you guys like, I don't play WoW, but it's like being part of a guild and going out fighting and doing missions and stuff. So it's very like an MMORPG kind of anime. And another anime that I'm watching is called Sakurasu no Petna Kanojoa. That's a really long name. Wow. But it revolves around a boy who ends up in this crappy dorm that's full of people that are special, as in they're kind of crazy, but they have extreme talents. And they all just so happen to be girls.
Oh, I seen that one too.
Shidosha! I'm not even finished with it. You watch more than I do.
Yeah, that's a premise though. Every anime does that. The whole harem is some lonely kid, and he's probably a loser, right? He has no life. It probably sucks. And then he gets sent to a place full of women, and they like him for some weird ass reason. That's just like,
yes,
anime like 101. Yeah. I am a weeaboo. Fuck.
For people who don't know, a weeaboo is basically what's equivalent. I don't even want to say the word.
I was going to say pervert, but nah, it's not really.
No, it's just like a funny little term. It's like when someone tries to be something that they're not. There's people that try really, really hard to be Asian.
They type with weird smileys, say desu for no reason. I don't even know what the hell that shit means.
And they eat pocky sticks. Wait, is it called
pocky? I'm so Asian. It's pocky and ramen, yes.
When someone tries to be so Asian and it's clear they're not, then they call them a weeaboo. 4chan taught me that.
Aww.
Okay, that's cool. So what are you pimping out, Sally? Are you promoting anything you need to disclose?
No, not at the moment.
Dosha, what about you? What you watching? What you playing? What are you into?
I'm actually trying to catch up on all of this media-related stuff in regards to Wolf of Wall Street. So I've been I got that, and I'm gonna watch that.
Well, I have that movie. I need to watch it too.
Yeah. So I've been hearing a lot of stuff about it. I also read some news about the actual people and how they scammed a lot of money. So, you know, I heard it was a pretty funny movie, and it's pretty sinister what these dudes did. So I want to see what the hubbub is about. And actually, I confess I, too, jumped on the anime bandwagon and caught up with some stuff that I hadn't seen in a while. I'm not big into anime like I used to be back in the day. Let me tell you, I was a big, fat, desu-ass kid. That's why I know the feeling, you know? I was Pocky Ramen Boy back in the day, so...
Aww.
Yeah, that was me. So I was watching, like, Tonagura for some reason, and Spice and Wolf as another one, and... Yeah, I need to stop doing that shit. Oh, my God.
last time you admitted that you never seen Game of Thrones.
No, I did not.
What's up with that? You still haven't?
You need to watch it.
No, not yet. Yeah, I've been trying to play catch up, especially now because I'm trying to study, you know, different acting styles for future roles and crap that I have to do. I don't know. Just that and Sherlock Holmes I've been trying to catch up with. So I need to get on that. And I finally finished. Well, actually, that. What else? Supernatural. I got to finish Supernatural. Got to finish Supernatural. I'm a Jensen Ackles fan. It's pretty cool. And Jared Padalecki, they off the hook. I like them dudes. So I got to finish watching that.
Game of Thrones season 4 is coming up pretty soon, dude.
That's fine.
You better catch up.
That's fine.
Just binge. You can just binge and watch the whole. It's a good series, man. I don't see
how. I don't know, man. I might miss my gym schedule doing that, though. I'm scared. Especially when it's a good series, you know you don't want to stop. You know how Netflix is. It's like a black hole. You know, you can't get out of it. It's ridiculous. It's so I'm a little nervous starting it, but I'll stop being a pussy and get into it.
Well, you got till March, till the season begins. I'm pretty sure it's March. I don't know. I've been watching Aliens, all the Aliens movies. I'm trying to, because the new game is coming out, Alien Isolation, for the X-Bone. I'm totally not pimping it or promoting it. I don't know shit about this game. I know the last Alien game, what was it called? Alien Comrades? Alien? It sucked.
The one that was bad, yeah.
It was really bad. And this one looks cool. And so I'm watching all the special editions of the Aliens movies, all 4 of them, back to back. I watched the first 2. I was like, damn, this is a good series. And all these games have just sullied Ripley's image. But anyway, so I'm into the Aliens thing. That's pretty much it. I'm still playing GTA and Call of Duty on that crap. Noah, what are you into? What are you watching? What are you playing? What's going on with you?
I've been hooked on Twitch recently. I spend, like, whenever I'm not doing school, I'm not going to classes, not doing homework, I'm on Twitch, and I'm either streaming myself or watching other people stream. I don't know what it is, man. Like, the feeling of, like, being able to interact with people. It's like making a YouTube video that's live, and you get to interact with the people as you go, and you get to, like, do crazy stuff. Like, when people subscribe or follow or whatever, I have like a song that comes up on stream that's like just one of the songs where you just want to dance to it, and like I just go crazy on the stream. It's funny for everyone, or either that or they're just laughing at me, and I don't know, but
I wish you let me ban somebody in your chat.
Dosha showed it the other day. I made him a mod in the chat. I don't know, I just have fun with it. And whenever I'm not streaming myself, I'm watching other streamers, watching all the cool little layouts that they have, the different things that they have in the chat, the little bot commands. They have some cool stuff, and I've just been trying to improve my stream. And other than that, I'm just like eating Nutri-Grain bars, and that's about it.
Well, that's great. And this message has been brought to you by Nutri-Grain, your source for fiber. No, that sounds cool. Do you ever like invite people to like play the game with you and stuff, or?
Normally, if I have like anyone who wants to, anyone like other YouTubers, people who just want to come out and hang. I don't really ask every single time I'm streaming, but if anyone shows up to the stream, they're like, "Hey, can I pop in with a few games with you?" I usually say, "Yeah, hop on." If I have some viewers who want to play, sometimes I'll just set my Steam profile to joinable. They can hop in, play some Gary's Mod with me. I recently uninstalled League of Legends from my computer because
smart man.
No, it was so bad. Like I was just spending too much time on the game, and I had such a like I had 4 bad games in a row. Last one,
ranked.
And then ranked games, and then my last one, like 4 different people in the game, someone who wasn't even on my team, told me to uninstall. So I took their advice, uninstalled, and I'm saving that till the summer when I have some more free time. And
you gotta keep up on your games, dude. I haven't played Call of Duty in like three or four days, and I played it today, and I wasn't having the best time. I was kind of struggling a little bit.
It's
muscle memory, and you need to fucking work that shit like every day or every other day. You gotta be in the zone constantly. So like all these pro players, they're playing every fucking day, playing against super duper sweaty nerds, you know. So man, we didn't get to a lot of stuff. A lot of people want to talk about the pro players and stuff, but we've already passed an hour, so but we got links that, I mean, everybody knows, if people listen this far, they already know everyone's linked in the description, all that shit. Noah, thank you again for stopping by.
No problem.
And you're always welcome.
It's a blast.
And Miu and Shidosha, we have links to all their stuff. Shidosha is always answering all those creepy ass questions.
I know, he does.
Oh, and, you gotta see those, oh boy.
And Miu is always getting more and more followers on her Instagram with those lovely pictures that she's posting.
Those kawaii. Did I say it right? Kawaii. I'm trying to reach into my weeaboo right now. I'm kawaii. Okay.
His inner weeaboo. Right. But that's pretty much it. Anything else we need to pimp or promote or whatever?
No. I don't think so. Yeah, we're good.
All right. I'll see you next time then.
Adios.
Bye-bye.